I have had this senator saying so much that is untrue about the president. And this is not how to solve the problem. When some actors in the country, in the political space, get a look, there is no big criminal in this country without a big man behind him. When you unlock the door for one of the country's biggest criminals to bolt away, and then you go, you convince a judge that no, it is the army that let him go. So you that bailed him, what, there must be trust between yourselves. Bring him back, let him come and face justice. So to now say president is doing nothing is because there is impunity. And impunity is in the country because they are big men, VIPs. Yeah.
Well, you heard the accusation there. I mean, he was very categorical when he talked about, well, maybe he didn't mention your name, but I'm sure that you were very sure and clear that he was referring to the fact that you stood bail for Nnamdi Kanu, who is nowhere to be found as we speak.
You know, you know, I never expected anything else. This is just one of the things that make it difficult for us to have a conversation for a country that is undergoing this type of problems that we are undergoing. At every point you want to have a conversation, then somebody from the presidency turns around and becomes personal. You understand? And let me educate Garba Shehu. A judge said, you need a senator to stand shorty. And I did. And the military attacked the man before the day he was to come to court. And he escaped for his life. Then turning around, oh, you stood shorty for a criminal. What makes him a criminal? That is carrying flag and saying, I want another country. Is he carrying AK-47 in the bush and kidnapping people and killing people? So that is why it's always very difficult to have a conversation. The reason is that at all times, when you want to have this conversation, there's a fallback to